Hello and welcome back. In this lecture, we will discover some use cases of gRPC and how does it compare to REST. There are four types of gRPC. The simplest one is unary, where the client sends one single request message and the server replies with one single response. This looks somewhat similar to the normal HTTP API. Then we have client streaming. In this scenario, the client will send a stream of multiple messages and it expects the server to send back only one single response. Similarly, we have server streaming, where the client sends only one request message and the server replies with a stream of multiple messages. And finally, the bidirectional or bidi streaming. This one is the most complex because the client and the server would keep sending and receiving multiple messages in parallel and with arbitrary order. It's very flexible and no blocking, which means no sites need to wait for the response before sending the next message. Okay, so that's a very high-level overview of the four different ways of communication in gRPC. We will come back to this later on the hands-on lecture, where we implement each and every one of them to get much deeper understanding. Now, let's do a quick comparison of gRPC and REST to see their differences. First, gRPC uses HTTP2, which is, as you know, much faster than HTTP 1.1 used in REST. Second, gRPC uses protocol buffer to serialize payload data, which is binary and smaller, while REST uses JSON, which is text and larger. The API contract in gRPC is strict and required to be clearly defined in the proto file, while in REST, is often loose and optional. We can define it via open API if we want, but it's not mandatory. Code generation is built in gRPC with the help of the protocol buffer compiler. While in REST, we must use third-party tools like OpenAPI and Swagger. Both gRPC and REST communications are secured with SSL. Streaming is bidirectional in gRPC, while only one-way requests from client to server in REST. So gRPC is better than REST for most of the things that we have mentioned so far. However, there's one thing that REST is still better, that is browser support. While REST is fully supported by all browsers, the support for gRPC is limited, and it's required gRPC web with a proxy layer to convert between HTTP 1 and HTTP 2. So gRPC has a lot of strength, but it also has its own weaknesses. So where and when should we use gRPC in order to take full advantage of it? As you might have guessed, microservices is where gRPC really shines, since it enables low latency and high throughput communication, as well as strong API contract. gRPC is also suitable for polyglot environments because it provides code generations out of the box for many programming languages. Point-to-point real-time communication is also a good place for gRPC, since it has excellent support for bidirectional streaming. And finally, gRPC is a great choice for network-constrained environments such as mobile apps because of its lightweight message format. Alright, so now you've finished all the theory lectures of the gRPC course. Congratulations! I hope you enjoy it, and I will see you in the hands-on lectures.